Paris, in the Jazz Age. Thousands of immigrés and expatriates flocked to the city to pursue the frontiers of art. But one forgotten genius embodied the period's dynamism like no other, the great Australian dancer, Haydon Watson.
I mean, I was in love with him. We were all in love with him.
I was astounded by the way his body moved. It moved with such flow, such energy. It moved, perhaps, in a way nobody should.
April 17, 1928, at the Theatre des Champs-Élysées. Having arrived in Paris from Wollongong 3 days earlier, Haydon Watson ascends the stage to make his Paris debut. The city would never be the same again.
He was, in many ways, the apotheosis of European dance. The greatest dancer, in my view, that the world has ever known.
In this rare footage, rediscovered last year, the delights of Haydon's dance can be seen by a modern audience for the first time.
There was a dynamism, an athleticism, an exoticism, and, to be frank, an eroticism about his dance that had never been seen before on any stage. He was the soul of Paris.
In the months after his debut, Haydon begins socializing with the brightest lights of the Parisian artistic scene, including Picasso and Salvador Dali.
Person in Scott and Zelda Fitzgerald's marriage. As the 1930s began, Haydon became increasingly obsessed with his magnum opus. He wanted to express the entire works of Nietzsche using only the Macarena. And he and the Fitzgeralds grew apart. I think the end of that relationship destroyed Scott.
Ultimately, Hemingway was very envious of Haydon Watson. Ernest told me on a number of occasions that he felt emasculated by the fact that he could never master the Gangnam style in the same way as Haydon. And so in the winter of 32, he killed Haydon Watson in a duel on the Rue de Rivoli.
The 20th century had prematurely lost one of its greatest artists. Paris was in mourning for more than 2 months.
And it's all so sad because looking at that footage of Haydon, it just reminds one of the great emptiness of the talents of today who owe everything to him. And yet, Haydon Watson has been so totally forgotten. It's a great shame. A great shame.